This is 40 years I've been in politics. 40 years. 40 years later, you're telling me about changing my approach to speaking to people in Tobago? If after 40 years, then change now? But if you are describing and making recommendations to me that I should not say these things, one, or I should not say them so, well, it's the only way I know. Don't get drunk with the THA results. We don't get involved with stupid talk.
I see hate. Mr. Speaker, I see bitterness. Mr. Speaker, I see acrimony. Mr. Speaker, I see animosity. And Mr. Speaker, I see a man completely out of control. Completely out of control, Mr. Speaker. That is what I see. And that problem is not a new problem to me, you know. I was aware of the tendency for the Honourable Member to go out of control since 1987. Argue your case. Everybody has a chance to do it. But not like my good friend. The minute you oppose my good friend, Mr. Speaker, the minute you oppose my good friend, he gets very, very angry. And if you oppose him strongly, Mr. Speaker, he becomes a raging bull. And that is what this government is not prepared to accept. That is what it was. We just were not prepared to accept that.
That is what it was. We just were not prepared to accept that. And Mr. Speaker, you don't know the trouble I see. You don't know the trouble I see. I have had to live with that for 12 years. When you can't have your way, and when he cannot have his way, Mr. Speaker, his method is to bully. That's what it is. His method is to bully you. That is what I fought against. That is why his employment was terminated. Mr. Speaker, we do not tolerate bullying in the secondary school system. We're not tolerating bullying in the cabinet. We're not tolerating it. And if the member for Diego Martin West wishes a cabinet in which bullying is the order of the day, he's going to have to form that cabinet himself. It ain't going to happen in this one. It's not going to happen. He must learn to behave. I don't know if the member realizes it. I don't think the member realizes it. That when you carry on with hate that you have, it impairs your judgment. It impairs your judgment. That is what it does. And therefore, your prescriptions are not straight.
The commissioner wrote a letter stating that a high office holder intercepted the chairman of the Police Service Commission at President's House.
Those are your words and those are his words.
But my specific question is...
Yes, let me hear the question.
Did anyone from your cabinet intercept the chairman of the Police Service and provided information?
To the best of my ability, to the best of my knowledge, I'm the only person who goes to President's House from my cabinet. That's to the best of my knowledge. I'm the only person from the cabinet. So all this speculation about someone, if you want to say the Prime Minister when the President says so. But high-ranking official. I'm the only official in the cabinet who goes to President House to conduct state business. Right? And I've said, I have given from my office information to the Police Service Commission by its chairman. Why is that so difficult to understand? What the chairman does with that information is another story. How the chairman handles it is another story. So all this fancy footwork and trying to unravel and untie something, there's nothing to untie. I have given information which I believe was pertinent. I gave that information to the Service Commission. I have been to President House. So what is the speculation about? What the President said? There's nothing to speculate about. If you want to hold it and say I should not have given that to the Service Commission, I said, well, I don't agree. If you want to say I should not have gone to President's House, I would say that you are out of place. You can't tell me when to go to President's House. As Prime Minister, I go there as often as required. So that whole scenario, that whole period of Kankatang, I'm not joining it. As a matter of fact, with respect to the Commissioner of Police himself, I did say to the country at a press conference that we have contrary legal advice. This matter is going to be interpreted because we have a number of different legal positions. It came to pass, that was so. It got before a judge. The judge made a ruling. The government is responding to the ruling, and others are responding as well. The parliament is responding. So what is the problem? I know that there are people who would like to believe and make their interpretation. A high-ranking government official. And who is high-ranking official? Say the prime minister if you wish. That doesn't change one thing as far as I'm concerned. I'm simply doing my job. I'm simply doing my job. I could tell you the conspiracy theories about this conspiracy. There's no conspiracy. It's wide open. Wide open. That we have a problem here. It has been raised. It went to the appropriate quarter. And of course, it caused certain reactions to have been made. And of course, we have dealt with it. Didn't I tell you that the president will seek to find people to serve on the commission, and as soon as those people are found, the government will ensure that they come to the parliament and the parliament deal with it? I told you so. And it has happened.
Prime Minister, do you think the results on Monday suggest that your popularity here in Tobago may be waning as well?
What popularity I had in Tobago? Why do you think anybody votes a government out because it's popular? And that is why when you're in office for long, it's difficult to have those people see you as their savior. As far as they're concerned, you are there and you have done nothing. And if those points, as they were made, are deemed to have been bullying people, well then, so be it. Listen, I have been around, this is 40 years I've been in politics. 40 years. 40 years later, you telling me about changing my approach to speaking to people in Tobago? If after 40 years, then change now? But if you are describing and making recommendations to me that I should not say these things, one, or I should not say them so, well, it's the only way I know. Don't get drunk with the THA results. We don't get involved with stupid talk. So when you talk about carnival like Juve morning and carnival bands and people winding up on one another, we're not going to have that. And your desire to wind on somebody is low down the totem pole of priorities.
How much of a wake-up call was Monday's results for you and for the PM?
Well, it is, as I said earlier, I mean, we are down now, very far down, and it is a requirement to pick ourselves up and rebuild to be in a much better position.
Will this be your last THA election as Prime Minister?
I don't know. I don't know.
As political leader?
I don't know. I'm not one of those who claim to be able to see around the corner.
I ask this in the context of what you said on the campaign platform back in 2020 in terms of you not seeking another two.
Maybe I was still around the corner.
That position that you took then, are you still standing by that position?
When I have something to tell you about that, I'll let you know.
The leader is.
When I have something to tell you, I'll let you know. Right?
Is this our Prime Minister? What do you guys think about what Patrick Manning said? Are you seeing this today? Was he speaking the truth? Do you agree with him? Let me know in the comments, and of course don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and to hit that notification bell so you could get updated videos when I post and upload. But I don't know what to say. I'll leave you guys to comment, but one thing I will say, he seems to be living up to what deceased Honorable Patrick Manning said. 1 minute he's not going up again for PNM now, he can't see around the corner, and then maybe he could see around the corner. I don't get it. This man has confused me, and it is public knowledge. Tobagonians think you are a bully. I gotta go. I have to go. I got to go. But before I go, you know what I always say. We were born to love, and we learned to hate. Peace.